Hi, this is Mandy from Miu Art Studio, and I'm in Scotland doing soup painting today. When I was doing workshop, and then the feedback I get from people is that because it's very, very therapeutic, and it's very calm, and it's very relaxing. So I will soon upload more like easier design for the beginners to start your journey on soup painting. I'm going to show you step by step how I painted this silk scarf. It's originally designed by a French artist. Whoever watching this video, and I wish you keep your good health. In the meantime, please take care and be happy. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you're enjoying this tutorial. Okay. We need two paint brushes, a large size and a medium size, a bottle of Gutta, silk painting thinner. If you don't have thinner, that's okay. You can just use water and some color. Your palette and a dropper. Iron. Kitchen towel. That's all we need. So once you get everything prepared, and we can start now. By turn the silk to the back side and ironing it. It is just for keeping the surface flat, straight, so it's easier for coloring. In this part, I'm stretching the silk into the frame. And this frame is homemade. It's only like a 4 wooden bars and screwed together on the corner. So it's very easy to make. Sometimes when we planning to start to do something, we always want to spend to get everything perfect. But when I was starting, I was like that too. And I bought a few different set of frames, and then it just come out that they are very easy to make at home. So I watched some tutorial online and I just made my own one. When you make your own one, it's cheaper and then it's adjustable. I mean, if the size doesn't right, you just cut new wood and make another one. So please check the description. I have linked out some of the tutorial about how other silk painter they make their frame, because I have never made a frame tutorial. There's a lot of good ones. Just check it out. Now it's zoomed in to the big head of the leopard. And it is straight up. The easy and correct way to do silk painting is laying it flat on the surface, a table or a flat frame. But I did this one, I straight it up. So it's just for the recording. It's make it harder to paint. So you see the shadow behind the picture, that's me walking behind. Because yesterday I watched the artist tutorial, he keeps apologizing, his shoulder is in the way. So I think maybe I can do it from behind. So I just, when you see color, that's me painting behind the silk. I start with coloring the black dot on the leopard. That's because if you are new in silk painting, and this is a good start, you will get used to your paint brush and you will have an idea how to load your paint. And for the bigger circle, bigger spot, you need to load a bit more color. And then for the smaller spot, you just load less. In this part, I'm using a half loaded paint brush. And sometimes you can see I'm moving the brush tip to fill it up. But when in a silk painting, if your brush has a lot of paint, you don't have to move it. It's the silk will absorb everything. But then it's a danger if you load too much paint, it will leak down or go over the Gutta outline.
Here I am fixing the losing Gutta bit to keep the black in the place. You see that little gap there? If I don't fix it with a Gutta, the color I'm putting in there will run out to the background. So when you're painting, when you get your outlay scarf, check it as you go. You don't have to check it for when you start. It's very difficult. It's a lot of lines. And then when you're coloring, just check each circle if they're fully closed by the Gutta. If it doesn't, you fix it a little. You fix the gap yourself. And then wait until it dries. Make sure it's completely dry, and otherwise it will not be able to hold the dye in there. As I move into coloring those leaves, there's a traditional soot painting skills or technique is to transforming the light color to the dark color. It's like you wash it over and over until the transform. It's very smooth and natural. So I just keep doing it and until I feel happy with how the result looks. You can try both. You can try, it doesn't matter if you put the dark color first or the light color first, just try it out. I sometimes will do, sometimes from dark to light, sometimes from light to dark. And then you see on the corner, some of the dye, it's coming through, coming out of the shape, that because that part of the Gutta line was weak and my paint was load a bit too much of the paint. So, but for this scarf it's okay because the edge, you see later when it's finished, the edge is darker than the leaf, so it will cover it off. But those leaks are sometimes unavoidable, and sometimes I will wash it. If you sometime I will show you in my other tutorial, like how to save your painting. But when it's handmade, like we can't expect something perfect because it's impossible to make anything perfect. Sometimes I found my best painting come out, it's because I trying to fix the problems, and then it's become something out of my plan but look great. So I'm happy to leave it like that. And now I'm going to move to the back of the painting. When a shape's like this, about one subject, and then the same color apply to a big area. When it's need a transform, and I prefer to do it from the back, because that means I don't have to paint over the Gutta outline. I can leave them very clean, and also the transforming looks more natural when you do it in a bigger area. You can see the second one just look tidier than the first one, but it depends on how you like it. You can try it on a different way, and also you don't have to do the transforming. You can if you're not very comfortable with using silk painting, if you're not used to silk painting, you can just color it different, each shape with a different color. For filling the background and the edges, it's only one thing you need to take care of. It's once you start, try to finish the whole area which with the same color. From my experience, when I was painting bigger or long scarves, and in the early days, I didn't know this trick. And I would just mix some color and then start doing my background. And then I realized I don't have enough paint to finish it all. So I stopped and I mix more color and come back. And then I've realized the old color, the edge is dry. And so when I try to continue to pick it up from where I stopped, and it's always leave a very hard edge. And I really don't like it. It annoys me a lot because I can't get rid of it unless I paint the whole background again. So try to avoid it or test it out yourself. You learn from your own experience. So when I paint this leopard, I load my big brush, fully load a lot of paint on it because I need to quickly go through all the gaps between those spots to make sure the surface is wet when I'm applying the darker orange, which like to build up some shade. So and then I use the same brush. I just dip in the darker orange, only the tip, and then I'll go for the darker area. If you can see some place look more orange, and then the other place more pale, that's the same brush. And then when it's going to paint the really orange part, I use my media paint brush to load just the orange, no other colors. And then to apply on top of the damp surface. The last part of this painting is to check any bit missing or any shape you wasn't sure what it was at the start, because all the Gutta outline is in one color, so I wasn't sure if some gap is belong to the background or the foreground. And now when you finish the foreground, and then it's clear it's a background.
Life to look good even without mask. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to dye a silk scarf like this one, and you can also use as a mask, and you can make it into any color. Also, it's only going to take 5 minutes. Don't forget to subscribe. See you next time. Bye.